Hey everyone, I'm Charlene Habermeyer of Good Parenting Brighter Children, and this is Tidbits of Wisdom for Parents. Today I want to talk to you about a subject that's going to help your child's brain in the motor, auditory, and visual areas, and of course it pertains to music. But this is five different ways that I've come up with of ways that you can introduce music to your children. And you're probably thinking, why do I need to do that? Well, let's say you're going to take them and you're going to be part of the musical community. You want to take them to a musical play or an opera or even country western or whatever it is that you're going to take them to. What you want to do is you want to introduce them to the music before you go so that they will enjoy it better. We just enjoy the familiarity of it. And maybe during the holiday season, you're going to take them to a ballet like the Nutcracker. You want them familiar with the story and the music. So here are five ways that you can incorporate having them understand and fall in love with the music. Let's take the Nutcracker, for instance, and we'll use it as the example. So what you want to do is you want to get a CD and you want to play the music. So what they're going to be doing is they're going to be listening to the music. You can play the music maybe while they're studying or they're in the shower or the bath or playing in the house or whatever. You can have that music playing in the background. The second thing you want to do is you want to dance and move to the music. One thing I had in our house is I had like a bucket, and it was filled with scarves, feathers, ribbons, all different kinds of things that my kids could take out when their friends were there, and they could dance and move to the music. And they like especially if you as parents get up and you dance and move to the music as well. Now, when you're listening to the music, that develops the aural skills. When you're dancing and moving to the music, that's developing your motor skills. The third way is I hit all kinds of rhythm instruments. And so what we would do is everybody in the family got a rhythm instrument, we'd turn the music on, and then we would use whatever that rhythm instrument was. We would have it in the same cadence, the same rhythm as the music that we were listening to. It's just another way of moving, and it's another way of introducing them to the music. Oftentimes we would get up and we would march around using our rhythm instruments as well. The next way is we would actually sing the music. Now, if they didn't have any words, and most of them didn't have any words, then we would just sing ooh or ah or loo or whatever, and we would just sing. Now, that also helps to develop the auditory cortex as well. The last thing we did, and this was actually my favorite, is I would supply all kinds of paper, pens, markers, crayons, all kinds of things, and we would draw what we heard. We call it draw what we hear. And so we would all sit down, I would turn the music on, so we had listened to it, we had danced to the music, we had used rhythm instruments, we had sung the music, and now we were drawing what we interpreted, what we were hearing. So it was another opportunity for them to draw. Then what I did is I would take their drawings and, you know, give it a title, and we would put it on the bulletin boards throughout the house. So again, those are five ways that you can use to introduce your child to any music. I talked earlier on another one of these tidbits about the magic flute. That's another one. You can take that music and you can do all of those different five elements to help them so that they're very familiar before you actually take them to see the magic flute or the Nutcracker or whatever else that it is. Again, you're listening to the music. You are dancing to the music, you can sing to the music, you can use rhythm instruments to the music, and last, you can draw what you hear. Hopefully that will help you in introducing your kids to some of the great music out there prior to going to and visiting the musical community. Thank you for joining me, and I'll see you tomorrow.